In the project, we also study the socio-economic consequences, such as on job creation. We study the impact on nature and on our environment. We study the safety of our varieties, and we generate awareness with the public about the varieties and about the way we make them.
Why is this important? Stakeholders and consumers in the European Union have been reluctant so far to adopt food from genetically modified plants. Genome-edited inulin, however, might be perceived in very different ways. Because of the benefits for the consumers, the technology used, and the very small genetic changes involved.
The method of delivery of genome-editing molecules to plant cells and the manner in which they are subsequently being removed may be relevant for the level of public adoption of these techniques and of edited plant products. Each of these four methods will therefore carefully be analyzed to see how well they work, how expensive they are, and how accurate the edits are.
Furthermore, we're also using the same techniques in order to reduce the presence of bitter compounds that hinder the extraction of inulin.
Inulin production, it is an issue because the substances present in the latex, in particular sesquiterpene lactones, interfere with its extraction. On the other hand, sesquiterpene lactones and other substances present in latex have a defense function and potentially interesting biological activities that could be used in the pharmaceutical or agricultural industries. One part of work package 3, therefore, is dedicated to better understand how these sesquiterpene lactones are produced. This is done by a combination of metabolic engineering in yeast, biochemical assays, or knocking out the biosynthesis genes in chicory. In a second task, we aim to identify genes that are required for the development of laticifers, which are the cells where the latex accumulates.
In order to compare the technical different techniques used in chick, we are evaluating a common single guide RNA for all four concepts. For this purpose, we are collecting data as efficiency of the editing, time, effort, and money invested to regenerate a plant, but also the rate of non-target mutations in related genes and also in other regions of the chicory genome. Additionally, a toxicological analysis is performed using the terpenes produced by the chicory to test them for toxicity, but also for use as an anti-inflammatory agent, anti-cancer drug, or as an antibiotic.
Environmental impacts of the chic process are investigated via life cycle assessment. Consequences for the economy are derived via multi-regional input-output models. Both assessments study the whole value chain from breeding over cultivation, harvesting to the new chicory products. In addition to the quantitative impact evaluation, we study also societal issues either hindering or supporting innovation in chicory breeding. This is done by qualitative interviews and focus groups of targeted stakeholders.
By using workshops, questionnaires, and interviews, we would like to get the views of stakeholders on this type of technology we are developing. On top, we have a small stakeholder group providing advice during the entire project.
We have a specific communication plan per type of audience. These are researchers, industry and farmers, policymakers, and consumers. A great effort is being made to reach all these groups in terms of the type of language and the tools to be used. Consumers are a very sensitive group in CHIC project. We are using communication tools that represent an innovation in scientific communication, such as the activities carried out between artists and scientists, or using deep tech, like virtual reality or augmented reality, to produce educational games for teenagers.
We are examining how these samples are affecting to, for example, the gut microbiome. And for the bioactive terpenes, on the other hand, we are exploiting many different types of bioassays. For example, we are measuring the anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, antimicrobial and antioxidative effects of these bioactive terpenes. And we are also interested in seeing whether these terpenes might affect to biofilm formation of the microbes.
We can also evaluate the profitability and the feasibility of the terpene production, which eventually should end up here as well.
Furthermore, in Work Package 1, a number of other research tools are being developed that should facilitate the future breeding of novel chicory varieties. First, we have generated an improved chicory genome sequence. And secondly, a much needed solution is sought to overcome chicory's self-incompatibility. Self-incompatibility is a plant characteristic that prevents it from producing seeds from its own pollen. So to make seeds in chicory, one will always have to outcross the plants to other plants with different genes.
In this way, we enable a cheaper extraction of more health-promoting inulin for gut health.
Finally, a range of bioassays, antibacterial, antifungal, anti-inflammatory, are being carried out to identify which substances in chicory roots, and in particular in latex, possess biological activities of interest for human health.
With all this knowledge generated in Web Package 4, we aim to provide a science-based opinion for decision-making and risk assessment of new plant breeding techniques by using data of crop plant redesigned biotechnologically and improved for industrial use.
We are making an exploitation strategy for the both high quality dietary fiber and bioactive terpenes to see which are the most promising of these NPPT chicory lines.
The main objective is to provide them with the right arguments so they can make informed decisions about whether or not a food produced using gene editing techniques is healthy and sustainable.
We envision a future where there is not one chicory variety, but there are many chicory varieties that make different products, different health products. The farmer can then choose which variety he wants to grow based on, for example, market needs or societal needs. Come and visit our website.